All right, folks, my first guest was an original Not Ready for Primetime player on Saturday Night Live, and he's appeared in numerous films, including the Ghostbuster movies and Driving Miss Daisy. His brand new CD, Have Love Will Travel, will be out this Tuesday. You can also see him tomorrow night when he hosts Saturday Night Live with musical guest Beyoncé. Please welcome Dan Aykroyd.
Real good. Thank you. Played our signature tune there. What a band.
Isn't that an amazing band?
Yeah,
amazing. That's the best band in late night television.
I would say it is. I agree.
Would you say that? Would you say that's the best band in late night TV?
Yep. I like Mr. Schaefer.
That's right. Paul Schaefer's an old friend of yours.
But, you know, I've got a good driver there sitting in for Max.
Yeah, he's very good. Mr. James
Thank
Wilmore.
You.
Yeah. An amazing cat.
Really good. I've always wanted to play with this band. I really have.
Well, we're going to get to that a little later. That's a little surprise for later on.
Okay.
How dare you go out of order? Who do you think you are?
I just got into the building, and I'm learning. Yeah. I'm relearning.
Exactly.
You know, I used to have keys for every door in this building.
That's right, because we're just two floors away from the Saturday Night Live studio.
Yep. I used to have a ring of keys, and I used to find roof gardens and secret offices, and there's a room right at the top of the building. That was an old radio transmitter room. It was
right.
Had a half door.
Mm-hmm.
And like, you know, that being John Malkovich, that half door room.
Right.
Kind of like that. So we used to go up there a lot.
And so you just used to creep around this building and steal things and pretty much...
Well, I looked through a lot of files, you know, flipped through executives' desks and, you know, that kind of thing. See what was going on. See if there was a chance of our deal being renewed.
Yeah,
you know,
yeah.
That kind of thing.
Sure,
what
yeah.
Everybody should do.
We all do that.
Yeah.
You know what I can't believe? This is your first time. You've made many guest appearances and surprise appearances. Your first time hosting Saturday Night Live. That's amazing.
Well, I didn't have anything to do in the monologue.
Right.
But now, after 24 years, I've figured out what I'm going to do in that spot. So.
And that's the reason you said I will host.
Yes,
because
I finally figured out what I'm going to do. Yeah.
You're not going to give that away, or you're going to.
Well, probably not.
No, okay. Well, that just made for some exciting TV right there, I think.
Yeah.
That's now.
Right.
You're a man of many talents. Obviously, you love music, acting, sketch performing, writing, producing. You also once authored a manual for prison guards.
I'm very proud of that.
Yeah, well, because you're a little bit of a Law and Order buff. It interests you.
Well, sure. Well, I worked for the Solicitor General's Office, the Canadian Penitentiary Service in Canada, as a Clerk 5. And
this is obviously before Saturday Night Live. This isn't a job you took, like, in 1988.
This is a college job.
Okay.
And I had a boss there named Fred Reeser. Fred Reeser! And he wore a bow tie like this, and he was a driven man,
Uh-huh.
He was in the Canadian intelligence, you know, and he used to just look like you're working. Don't do any work, but look like you're working. You'll stay here a long time.
Uh-huh.
Never mind, that's it. You know how to work and look like you're asleep and look like you're working at the same time?
Mm-hmm.
I said, well, how do you do that? And he showed me, and there's a way you can put your hand like this on, and you can, you know, move your finger and you can be sleeping, you know? So he taught me that. And
I've actually used that in interviews at key moments.
You can
look through old late night shows and see.
I hope not. No.
No. I'm right here, buddy.
So my job was to compile something that, you know, some big shot got to put his name on. And so I wrote a manual for deploying squads during riots.
Wait, so you're actually, you're considered an expert on controlling rioting...
Yeah, I could take this crowd now.
Yeah. What would you do if for some reason this crowd suddenly, because the weekend's near, they went crazy and they lost their minds? No. That's okay. But what if they started to get out of hand? What would you do to control the crowd as an expert?
Well, I'd try to get the band in there and try to soothe their spirits. No, actually, the best thing... one of the greatest weapons you can use in any is a fire extinguisher.
Seriously?
Yes, I would go to find the nearest fire extinguisher, yeah.
Yeah, and you'd get to like two of them and the rest would beat the crap out of you. There's like 210 of them.
Then you start swinging or kissing as I...
Yeah, yeah. Ladies are here. Now, you are also an auctioneer in Canada. Is that right? You have served as an auctioneer.
Yeah. We every summer we have an Auto Hulk auction. That's for cars that, you know, basically have no wheels and no, you know... We start the bidding at about a buck for them, but
who wants to buy one? I mean, who says, I gotta go get me a car with no wheels?
Well, you know, up where I live in Canada, back where, you know, a lot of overalls, well, there's guys who like to grab these things and fix them up. So we have an auction in the summer, and we sell these old Hulks, you know.
Right. And so you actually serve as an auctioneer for these events?
I do, yes. Mm-hmm.
And you can auction things?
I can. You got anything here you'd like to sell the audience? Maybe,
what do you want? What do you want? I don't know what I have right here.
Well, let me see. How about
I can't
this?
Let go of these two because I've had these on my desk forever. What's that? I have a mirror that I keep under here at all times. For like,
how about that? The cup that I just
drank? Oh, the Conan mug. All right.
All right, I got a cup here at Conan O'Brien Show, late night show. Cup right here. We'll start the bidding off at $1. Go up by increments of $1. $1 right here. Got a $2, $3, $4 bill right here. And a $5 bill. Put me the $5 bill right here. Hold me the $5. Hold me $6 right here. $7 right here. Hold me $8. Hold me up to $10. $10 right here. $10, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $11, $20 bid. 20. One, two, three. Sold.
Yeah!
$20. Would you make sure that one of the production people get that? We're going to give that to charity.
Yeah, where's the
$20 bid on the cup.
That was very nice. Did you get any money?
Yeah, he's going to give $20 to one of your production.
What do you mean he's going to give us $20? Make sure that pay. Don't let those people out of here until
we
get that.
That goes to charity.
That'll go to charity.
That will go to the New York Police Foundation for bulletproof vests.
Oh, that's nice. All right, $20. That's a good. I think we gotta go, right? We used up. Let me get to all these mentions before we get to the singing. We'll be you're gonna be hosting Saturday Night Live with musical guest Beyonce. Yeah. Have Love Will Travel will be in stores on Tuesday.
Yeah,
the,
this was
the new CD.
Just this photo here. This was taken after a 1,000-mile motorcycle ride. See?
Oh, let me get a shot of that right there.
That's this is Big after, Man, Big Music, yeah.
This is you two after riding 1,000 miles.
That's right.
You can tell See? You just ate a lot of bugs.
That's right.
And on June 5th, Dan will be performing at the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame in Cleveland, Ohio, and June 7th at the Mall of America in Minneapolis,
we are looking forward
Minnesota.
To that.
And you're going to play us out to commercial.
Yeah, we'll play a little bit of this song. If you like it, the record comes out. We'll have more on the record May 20th. So let's
take it away, Dan Aykroyd. Get over there.
Thank you.
This is a swinging party. You know I'm among friends. Every now and then, you know, the roof falls in. I've loved and lived and I've lived and lost. When Mr. Blues walks in, he says,
I'm your boss.
He makes me cry. Don't you know he makes me cry? Y'all go on with the party. Sadness in my heart. A long time ago, I loved and lost. A Mr. Blues walks up and says,
I'm your boss.
He makes me cry. My, 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 he makes me cry. My, my, my. Y'all go on with your party. I'll be all right in a little while. Play that guitar. I get a sadness in my heart. A long time ago, I loved and lost. Now Mr. Blues walks up and says,
I'm your boss.
He makes me cry. Oh, my, my, he makes me cry.